Now, this very colorful painting is titled Gli Alberi Giallo da Bibbiano, which is the yellow trees from Bibbiano. It's a 36 by 48 oil on canvas. And before we talk about the painting, I'd like to talk a little bit about the Casali di Bibbiano, which is a beautiful 90-acre estate of vineyards, probably 15-20 minute drive from Montalcino. And as I mentioned before, we have spent many years visiting the Montalcino, the village of Montalcino. This was one of the first vineyards that we visited, and the story is the Casali is owned by a good friend of ours named Alberto Guadagnini, who's originally from Italy but has been a very successful restaurateur in the Philadelphia area and also Sarasota, Florida, which is our hometown. And that's exactly where we met him about 10 years ago at a restaurant in downtown Sarasota that he owned with his family called Salute. He also, when we met him, told us about this beautiful estate that he has very close to Montalcino. So I think it was 2013, Susan and I took a trip. It's about a 2-hour train ride, actually from Florence on the old train. And you get off, you change at Siena, and you get off at Buonconvento, and that's where Alberto picks you up. It's about maybe a 15-minute drive from Buonconvento, which again is in the foothills of the beautiful village of Montalcino. This beautiful estate is originally an 18th century country estate that Alberto had purchased several years ago. And it contains, as I mentioned, about 90 acres of vineyards, olive groves. They have absolutely beautiful villas there that sit about 26 people. They also have a beautiful pool, gym, tennis court. It's just a spectacular escape. And it, more importantly, it has some of the most delicious Super Tuscan wines that you'll have in the area. He has several varieties of Cabernet Sauvignon, Merlot, Sangiovese, and what we call, he calls the liquid gold, his really delicious, high-quality olive oil. So Susan and I visited there, and I did a ton of painting from several trips. We first visited in 2013, but we had several other trips. And this particular painting is a view from the back deck of the trees. These are some of these beautiful trees that change color in the fall. We were there in October, and this is just an incredible, colorful expression of what Bibbiano actually feels like. You can see the beautiful golds and the yellows of the trees blended in with some very sort of darkish blue olive trees in the background, and then these sort of pinkish brownish little spots in the field. And what that is actually is a golf course. It's called the Castiglione del Bosco, and it's owned by the Ferragamo family. And Alberto was kind enough to take me there as a guest to play the course. It's just spectacular. And again, the hills in the background are the hills that head up to the village of Montalcino. Now, this is the first in a series I like to talk about, so let's go on to the next screen. Now, on this screen, we have two more very colorful paintings from Castello Bibbiano. These are views from behind the main building and restaurant, and the ubiquitous cypress trees that run throughout Chianti are just sort of, in the top painting, they're almost militaristically in line, standing at attention, protecting the beautiful estate. The colors, again, in the top painting, obviously the cypress trees are the main focus. However, they're balanced very strongly with the backgrounds, which is that the immediate contrast is the beautiful Tuscan old dirt road that separates the trees from the vineyards. And you have the grapes and the trees as they turn yellow. As I mentioned, this happened to be in the fall. And then again, those beautiful violet and blue trees in the background, way in the background, Some are olive trees, some are cypress trees. And then, of course, those little pink and dark shades, that's from the Castellone de Bosco golf course at Ferragamo, backing into those beautiful soft violet hills of Montalcino. And then over on the right, we're balanced off with that bouquet of little red flowers that's balanced against the little field at the top, right behind the restaurant. The bottom painting, I did the top painting first, but then I decided to sort of concentrate on just one cypress. I'm just fascinated by the shape and the design, and they're just so stately and so beautiful. And this one pretty much dominates the entire painting. The painting is 20 by 24 inch, but it's a vertical. And again, the fields in the background, same sort of background as the top painting, and the grapes behind the tree. Again, just a typical scene that you will see in these beautiful hills the fields behind the hills of Montalcino. As I mentioned earlier, Casali di Bibbiano's estate is about 90 acres, and over the several times that we visited there, Susan and I would walk around the property and just take in these incredible sights. I would bring along a sketchbook and a camera, and these two particular paintings are very typical of the just incredibly beautiful landscape that surrounds this area. And it's almost the top painting is 24 by 32 inches. And I mean, if you would say such a thing as like a perfect landscape, it's just the way the color and the forms react in nature. And I'm just the person to interpret it with my own color images. But I mean, just if you just look at this and you see the road and then these two little houses that are perfectly situated in the middle of these trees, and in the background is just stupendous. I mean, those purple, violet, pinkish hills from Montalcino way in the background on the right, and the green trees, and then some more olive fields divided up by the just the perfectly designed fields, the green fields in the background, and that tiny little house over on the right. I mean, this is just, this is what draws you to Tuscany. I mean, it's really like you can't say too much about it, although I love to interpret the colors a little bit in my own mind, which probably makes it a little more colorful than real life. However, it's the feeling that I think I capture more than anything. Now, the bottom painting, I mentioned the top is 24 by 32. The bottom is a vertical of 20 by 24, and it's simply a close-up of the house that's in the middle on the right there, the small house. And again, there's not much you can say. It's just, look at how this is situated amongst the trees, and then the trees in the background. Again, being the autumn, you have those incredible changes of colors of the leaves. But again, so simple, so serene, and just walking around this incredible estate, the feelings are remarkable. And we're very thankful we're able to participate and create these landscapes. Now, the top painting, 24 by 32, is owned by Mr. Byron DeFore in Chattanooga, Tennessee, and the bottom painting by Ann and Jim McGee of Toronto, Canada, and Sarasota, Florida. Here we have another one of the pure landscapes from Casali di Bibbiano. This one, a bit more colorful than the previous two we discussed. It's all very much in the same area. But when I was back at the studio working on this, I wanted to see how aggressively I could become with the color, but still preserve the integrity of the landscape. And I think I succeeded in that. And this is a little more busy than the previous landscapes, but I really like the colors. There's a lot of this silver blue, but it works its way from the bottom through the middle and almost to the top over to the right of the hills there. And then there are two major hills close up, and then there's that soft blue pinkish hill way in the background, which is of Montalcino. I achieved from an artistic point of view the what I wanted to, because I think although the colors are strong, they really still have that beautiful feeling, and they emphasize more than some of the softer landscapes. They emphasize the perfect lines and the perfect form that is there in nature. It's just, it's a little more colorful, and the rendition is a little more focused on the little house in the middle, and it sort of balances off against those strong blues and the strong greens. Anyway, it's 24 by 32 inch. It's in the collection of Alan Kennedy at Cape Breton, Nova Scotia. Now here we have a couple more paintings from Casali di Bibbiano. These are a little different from the landscapes. They're actually close-ups of buildings that were in the previous landscapes. These are, the top is called La Casa di Contadino, which means the house, the peasant's house or the farmer's house. And the bottom is just simply called Due Case, two houses. The top one, let's talk about this first. This is a 20 by 24 inch painting, and it's almost regimental. If you see, it's almost like the house is standing, it's very proud standing in the midst of this beautiful garden and field. This is a throwback to some of my older building paintings where I spend a lot of time working on aging the building. If you take a look at the colors in the house, there's a lot of different colors that come through, but it has an overall effect of being sort of the Tuscan orange and brown with the slightly aging colors of gray. But it's a lot of blues, a lot of yellows, a lot of pinks, and it's a lot of work. It's not just brushwork, there's palette knife in it, and it takes quite a bit of time. And artistically, it works very well, in my opinion, with the soft grass in the field. And it also almost matches the colors in the road, the Tuscan road that's over on the left, heading towards the back garden there. But again, fairly realistic. The trees in the background are dark blue and green. This was actually also in early September. This, some of those other paintings were in the late fall, but this is early September, so the colors haven't really changed that much. But it has this wonderful, serene feeling that, your home, this little path on the left, it breaks up there on the right, it goes to the front door. It's just a very peaceful painting, and a little different from the one on the bottom. The one on the bottom, two houses, this again is a little later in October, and so we can see the trees in the background, almost like the autumn foliage in New England. But again, there's very similar work in this painting. These two houses, if you look at them, the first impression is sort of whitish. However, looking closely, you'll see it's the same thing. There's an awful lot of paint and an awful lot of color. Again, a combination of a brush and a palette knife. And it worked. There's some, you can see some violets over in the house on the left, and some blues, and there's slight shades of green, there's slight shades of purple, a little pink. But it's a lot of, it takes time. You overlay the paint. It's not, you let it dry because it is oil. And it takes, these paintings, although they're simple, they took a long time because of the amount of work that's basically in the two buildings. Now the one on the bottom has a little more flowers, a little more colorful in the fields. There's a lot of the rose colors, the purple, the blues again. But again, it's a really smooth and easy composition, has that wonderful feeling of being at home in the country. And again, this one is 20 by 24. This painting is in the collection of Cheryl and Tom Conklin in North Carolina and Sarasota, Florida. And the top painting is in the possession of Marilyn and Fred Martucci of Eastchester, New York. And she happens to be my sister. Now I would like to take a little break from discussing individual paintings to take a look at this photo, which was taken by Susan up on my rooftop studio on Via di Oriolio in Florence, which, as you can see, is about an arm's length from the beautiful cathedral, the Duomo, and the Campanella. And this was just an absolutely spectacular view that we had, and also a great place to work, because it's very important when you're working outside, when you start the paintings, as I did with all these, it's important to be able to finish them outside, because You have 360 degrees of light here. This particular day is in late November, and fortunately it was very sunny. Sometimes in Florence we get quite a bit of rain. But just to take a look at the painting on the left, that's one of the landscapes that we just talked about from Bibbiano. And the painting to its right is a close-up of the little house that's in the landscape. And then the other painting on the chair next to it and the painting on the top of the easel are from outside of Montalcino. But the bottom painting, again, was from Bibbiano. And this was a very beautiful fall painting of the yellow flower, the yellow trees, and the background. I mentioned that's the golf course from Ferragamo in the background, and also way in the back of the hills of Montalcino. But on the next screen, I'm going to talk about what happens when I take this particular painting that's on the bottom and decide to go a little more contemporary. And we're going to see that one right now. Now, this is an incredibly fun way to wrap up the series of paintings that I've done over the years at the from the Casali di Bibbiano. We talked about that last screen where I showed the painting that was on the bottom of the trees, and that was essentially the same image, the same location that these paintings are from. We returned to Bibbiano a couple of years after I did that painting. But the time we were there, we were with some friends, and I didn't really do any painting. It was very social, hanging out, having some fun, playing a little golf. But I did come back to the studio. It was late October, and I did have an image in my mind from what I had seen, although, as I mentioned, I didn't do any painting. So I come back and I looked at that painting that we just talked about with all those beautiful trees, which is essentially a view from the back of the main building and restaurant. And I decided to use that painting as the source for these three paintings. And the first one I did is the top one. And I just basically, this was an example of the fun that an artist can have in his studio, being inspired by paintings that he's done on site. All these three paintings were all done in the studio. And I said, the first one is the top one. Essentially, I preserved the integrity of the colors of the orange and the yellow of the trees, but I just put that really dark magenta purple background and then the soft blues. But pretty much the rest of it is just the gold and the yellow, which was the image I had in late October from our trip there to Bibbiano. So I did the bottom two paintings. The little one on the left is essentially just a branch. Very creative, in my opinion, but that same old magenta, because I love that balance. I think that balance with the magenta and the yellow and gold works. And if you look closely, there's a touch of that magenta in the branch itself. And of course, there's little highlights at the bottom, which kind of balance off. And then the other one on the right is a little more complex than the other two, because I do throw a background in. I do throw the fields and the little blues. And I have, again, my favorite purple magenta background. But right at the last minute, I put in that burst of yellow orange, and it's really not a sun. It's just sort of a balancing off of the very strong oranges and yellows. These colors are sort of brilliant colors. So anyway, I think it's a good idea maybe to just try and balance it off. I think these are all three totally different paintings, and it's sort of a take on Monet. Remember, Monet would paint the same scene over and over again, but basically just different lighting. This is essentially the same scene from the original painting I did of the five or six trees, but again, totally different paintings. So, as I said, a nice way to wrap up a wonderful series of work that was I did over the years from 2013 to 2018 from Casali Bibbiano. Thank you.